Respected guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and privilege to have you at the inaugural edition of Times Now Summit. As we begin a new decade, we as citizens and stakeholders in our country's future have a great responsibility in deciding how we face the challenges that lie ahead of us and the solutions we find for them. We are an economy that is aiming to touch $5 trillion by the middle of the decade. We are also a nation whose struggle for freedom and successful experience in democracy has inspired others. It's no surprise, therefore, that the eyes of the world are on us. We have to deliver on the promise of India. This can only be possible if India's citizens prosper, if its poor and marginalized are in a position to uplift themselves, if its diversity continues to remain a source of strength, and if its youth have the confidence and faith to realize their potential. Times Now Summit has been envisioned with a purpose to accelerate the vision of New India by taking a holistic approach in defining our goals and finding the best path to achieving them. I'm confident that the debates and discussions with India's influential voices through the course of the summit will contribute towards a collaborative and conclusive India Action Plan. I'd like to thank our esteemed speakers and dignitaries for agreeing to be part of this endeavor. We are privileged and honored to have Prime Minister Modi grace our event. Under his leadership, India's stature in the world has grown, and the massive mandate he received in the Lok Sabha elections is testimony of the hopes and aspirations that hundreds of millions in this country have vested in him. We are eager to hear his vision of a new India. I have no doubt that his thoughts and ideas will enrich and help shape our action plan. We at Times Network and at the Times of India Group look to the coming decade with enormous positivity. I'm confident that out of this summit will emerge a clear, concrete, and constructive ideas for India to soar higher. I once again thank Honorable Prime Minister, our dignitaries, and guests for their valuable time. Thank you.